a year, it feels longer though.
Ah, 3 years for me. Is it a great city?
Definitely. So what do you like most about it?
So what do you like most about living here?
Well, I love walking my dog in the park, especially on a pretty day.
I'm a little different, I guess. I'm more the kind of guy that likes walking his dog in the park on a pretty day.
No, I like that too. I just said so.
Do you have a dog?
Yes!
Are
you listening to me at all?
Do you like watching TV?
No.
Me too! You like Seinfeld?
You really are listening to me.
Me too! Have you ever heard a joke about the airline food?
No.
What's the deal with airline food? Hilarious. Classic. Cracks me up every time.
That's a good one. Listen, can we just see?
Seinfeld is still the funniest show on television. Serenity now! No soup for you.
This is ridiculous.
I'm telling you, his comedy is just a gift from the gods, you know what I mean? Every time I see a show or one of his movies, I'm just blown away. Have you ever seen the Bee movie?
Yes, I have.
You haven't? Stop what you're doing and bring it to now. That movie is so great.
Excuse me.
Really
good. Hello?
An interspecies romance and taking down the big guys in the audience.
Excuse me.
I'm telling you, Seinfeld is still the funniest guy to tell us.
Hello?
He reminds me of me, actually. He says I'm the funniest guy I've ever met.
Has he really said that?
I mean, he's entitled to his opinion, right? Sure, I'm funny, but I've got my personality flaws, too. Like, sometimes I'm too funny.
Really?
People don't realize when I'm being serious. Do you believe that? Anyway, I'm talking to a storm here. Enough about me. Tell me about you.
Or I could just leave now, since you're a self-centered jerk.
I'm a Capricorn myself.
Hi.
Hi.
It's nice to meet you.
You too. Julia's told me a lot about you.
Thanks. She's a great girl.
Yeah, she is. We've been friends for something like 6 years, I think. So much fun to be around.
Where did you meet? In school?
Yeah, we played soccer together. Both second stringers, keeping the bench nice and warm for everyone else. No, seriously. Julia's one of my favorites. And we have great taste.
That's very sweet.
So, are you hungry? I'm about ready.
I'm pretty hungry too. Listen, I can see you stealing things. You don't have to play it off like you're not.
What? What are you talking about?
See? Dude, you just stole a plate!
Don't run, kid.
That's a cool accusation.
Accusation? I mean, just watched you steal a sugar packet right now. How can you honestly believe I don't notice?
Look. I don't know what your problem is with me, but I see that this is very important. I better go.
Oh, wait. Look, if you stop stealing things, I'll get off your case, okay?
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Great. So, where are you from? I mean, I like sports as much as the next guy, but this girl was completely unhinged.
Yikes.
He was so over the top and creepy. I'm pretty sure he compared my eyes to shrimp.
Yikes.
Well, what about that girl Julia set you up with? Julia has great taste. She can't have been that bad.
Yes, remind me to thank Julia the next time I see her for signing up with a kleptomaniac. I mean, seriously, the girl can go one conversation without pocketing everything in sight.
Well, what about that guy in the bookstore? Lewis, you seem promising.
Yes, Lewis. God's gift to mankind. The most self-absorbed human being I've ever had the displeasure of speaking to. He wasn't even listening to me.
My prospects have been hopeless thus far.
You know, who needs love anyways?
I may as well just give up now.
No point in trying anymore.
Listen, bud, I've known you, what, since pre-K, and you're a hopeless romantic. You deserve to find happiness. You can't just give up that easy.
Sweetie, listen, it was only two bad days. There's so many other things to see. You can go that easily.
I guess you're right.
Best girl.
Now, stay back out there.
Anything and everything once I live on the edge. For me, it's all about intensity. going for broke, taking chances.
That's good outlook.
Yeah, for me it's all about living the extreme! There's a saying, if it's not extreme, it's not worth dream!
I like it.
Yeah, it took me a couple months to get the rhyming perfect. You know that Billy Joel song, Why Do I Always Go to Extremes? Or Why Do I Go to Extremes? It's like those basements. That's how much I love being extreme!
It's a good song.
It's my favorite.
Extreme?
Extreme!
So are you a snowboarder or an off-road vector or...
Oh, no. I'm way too busy to work to do anything like that.
So what do you do?
I'm an accountant. Yeah, I know. It doesn't sound too extreme. Extreme! But trust me, it gets pretty extreme!
Really?
Yeah, just look at tax forms. The W-9, the 1099, talk about intense. Sure, we all know that the Form 1040 is crazy, but the Form 1040 ES, off the hits hook!
I didn't hear that.
Yeah, I saw this little joke around the office that the ES and 1040 ES actually stands for EXTREME! Standard accounting procedure. I'm sort of known for my puns.
That's not really a pun.
But beyond accounting, I still like to say EXTREME in my spare time. Like something an old person does, I like to take it up a notch.
Really?
Yeah, I want to see. Jim, get here, let me show you. So a normal person would walk like this. But this is how I walk. And a normal person will do their name like this. But this is how I or a normal person might floss like this. But this is how I floss. Blows your mind, right?
Did you just floss on a date?
Oh man, that was so rude. I wasn't here.
I've been looking forward to this for a while now.
Me too. Sorry about
that. Oh shit, no big deal. Hold on. I forgot to.
What's up? What's wrong?
Oh, it's this silly little thing. I've got this pill that I need to take, or else I get a weird. Somewhere. You know, whatever. It's cool.
You sure? We could go to a pharmacy or something.
Nah, it's fine. It's just a precautionary drug. It won't kill me if I don't take it for one night. I just may be a little out of whack. You probably won't even be able to tell. So, anyway.
Anyways.
Nice to finally meet you.
The feeling's mutual.
Oh, yes. It's so awesome to finally put a face to the name.
Yeah, seriously.
You're funny. Oh, you're cute. Oh, he's not that cute. You just haven't been out in a while. I just thought, sure, he is good looking. Shh, you're embarrassing yourself. Quit freaking out. What? Why are you jumping all over me? She started it.
Too moist.
How about the shrimp scampi?
Too moist.
Oh.
I actually have a bit of hydrophobia.
Hydrophobia?
Is the fear of dampness or moisture?
Oh, well, what about the angel parmesan?
No, I probably shouldn't. Ophiophobia?
What's that?
It's the fear of the color purple.
Oh, you could get the cheese plate?
I probably shouldn't. Prosophobia?
Fear of...
constipation.
Okay, what about the sushi?
Ichthyophobia. It's the fear of...
raw fish, yeah, I got it. What about this? It's a Hawaiian fish, and it's not raw. Let's just see if I can pronounce it right.
It actually looks delicious.
Great!
But I actually suffer from a very rare case of hippomonchalophobia.
What is that?
The fear of long words.
Okay, so what about this? Just a peanut butter and jelly.
Sorry.
What could possibly be wrong with a peanut butter and jelly?
Arachnophobia.
What's that, the fear of sandwiches?
The fear of peanut butter sticking on the roof of your mouth.
Right, so what can you eat?
Not much. I do have xenophobia.
Fear of?
Food.
Right, so if you have all these dietary issues, then why did you invite me to dinner?
Good question.
Listen, why don't we just skip this and see a hockey game or something?
Ooh, Karen, pass the fist.
Play mini golf?
No.
See a musical?
Depends on the musical. I actually have a lorophobia.
Fear of?
Cats.
So what would you like to do?
Well, I actually have a few ideas.
Great!
But I have decidophobia.
Oh, great. How about I'll decide for you? How about we just call it a night?
Anuptophobia.
What's that? The fear of staying single for the rest of your life?
Actually, yes. Although it's probably best that we end this day now on account of my diagnophobia.
Fear of?
Dinner conversations.
Oh, great. Well, in that case, have a good night.
You too. One second.
So, what do you do for a living? You poor. I respect your profession. I think it's noble what you do. The world needs more people who climb in miserable ladders. But I really don't see how it's appropriate to bring your work on a date. Oh yes, quite the storm in here. I'm gonna use the restroom. No, I'm not leaving. I'm taking my coat with me because it might get cold in a minute. Yeah, cold like that. No, you stay. You... look, I don't know what that is. And you... oh my god! A box! A huge glass box! Falling from the sky! No!
Thank you.
sucks.
It's okay.
We both sort of saw it coming.
So what happened?
So how did you screw it up?
I don't know.
It had to be something. There's always something.
I don't know.
I'm not sure.
Maybe she got a little needy.
Maybe he got a little distant.
I'm so sorry.
You know what really sucks? You're over here pouring your heart out. And I go and make it worse by doing a 40-yard play action pass. And touchdown! Sorry.
It's all right. I should stop moving anyway.
What are you going to do?
I think I'll take a break.
What do you think I should do?
No. I think you should keep that with me.
It's not too soon for that.
It's never too soon for that.
Are you sure that's a good idea?
What's a good idea is quiz. What Q or triple letter board score? Oh, really, really good idea. Sorry, you're saying?
Do you really think I should start dating again?
Yes.
Right away?
Rebounding is a crucial part of social health.
There's no other option. You've got to find someone to distract you from.
And even as it worked out, we have a valid lesson here today.
What's that?
3 times Q is 30.
After you obliterate somebody 62-7, you lose the feeling in your thumbs.
You're a real pal.
Yeah.
Hey everyone, I'm on a date with a celebrity! I think my phone's out!
hang up the phone. We're on a date, and you spent half the time shrieking with your friends, and the other half setting up rendezvous. I have to say, it's really disrespectful.
That was impossible.
What?
A 10-year-old girl needs a heart transplant.
Oh, no.
So thank you. Thank you for completely disrespecting a child's life.
I'm sorry, I had no idea.
No, you didn't have any idea.
I feel terrible.
Well, you should.
Music, groovy makeouts, cool ranch Doritos, and wait. Those priorities are the music, groovy makeouts, cool ranch Doritos, lady love.
On the same way.
I can see that look in your eyes. Your eyes are saying, play me a song right now.
My eyes are not saying that.
Oh, I probably shouldn't anyway. I haven't tuned up in a while.
I do not want you to play a song in this restaurant.
Oh, anything for my lady.
No, I'm really serious. I'm okay. No, listen. I want you to sit back down and... No, please not.
Listen. Oh, come on. I've been ready for this all week.
No, listen. I don't know if you know this, but there are other people in this restaurant. Guitar Hero, seriously?
Oh, legal, right? She has like a dream.
It's not even a friend.
What? I can't hear you. The music is overpowering.
Ha ha ha!
referring to living history. I thought that meant that you occasionally did Civil War reenactments, not that you'd come to a date pretending to be a pirate.
Pretending?
Yes, pretending.
I'd be as real as you don't as you'll ever meet.
And do all real pirates shop at H&M?
Arr.
Hi. Hello. So, on your listing, it said you're a psychiatrist. Do you like it?
Oh, no. That was a typo.
Oh, you're a psychologist?
Psychic.
Ah.
So.
So, what's it like?
Man, the predatory field is rough. Like, just last week, I read in the stars that I was going to get a sunburn on July 8th. So I had to cancel my trip to Cancun.
Oh.
I know what you're thinking. Sunburns are the worst.
Right.
See how I know what you were thinking?
So, how did you first decide you'd become a psychic?
I remember exactly when it hit me. I was a freshman in college, and I envisioned I was going to fail a math exam. And I took the exam, and I failed. Isn't that amazing?
Yes.
That's the moment I knew I'd become a psychic. Then 4 years later, I became a psychic. That's another prediction come true.
But all of those are actions you can control.
How about I give you a freebie?
That's okay, I'm fine.
Oh no, I insist.
Really, I don't think I feel comfortable with this.
Does he feel comfortable with this? It is decidedly so.
All right.
Lend me your left hand. Interesting, very interesting. This crease between your thumb and your pointer is your lifeline. I like to see a big arch and a clear impression. That indicates vibrancy and health. Yours is, well, that's not great. But on the edge of the hand beneath the pinky is your marriage line. If the line goes up as yours does, well, it seems like you won't be getting married anytime soon. Oh, but if I look here, I can see a second marriage line. That indicates that you'll be involved in a rather messy and tumultuous love triangle. Won't that be thrilling? Oh, if I look at the center of your hand, I can see that you like sports. Is it true that you like sports?
I like sports.
Yes, I see that right here. Sports. Let's see. Your history line is right here. Let's have a look. Sometimes you have to... There we go. When you were a teenager, did you go to high school?
Yes.
That sounds about right.
Listen, can I have my hand back? You haven't really told me anything that's not obvious.
Oh, well, here comes the big finale.
That's okay, I'm fine.
The main line is located on the top of the hand, beneath the fingers. But your line is remarkably faint. Have your job getting a read. There we go. Are you ready? You have two sisters, one redhead, the other blonde. You're 5'8". You love movies. You consider yourself politically independent, and you're a Virgo rising. Well done.
That's amazing. I realized one of those things was completely true. How could you possibly know all of that?
I see in your hand.
Wow. What else can you tell me? Can you tell my future?
Your organs. Your credit card is a Visa ending in 8235. And after April 30th, you can no longer purchase two large one-topping pizzas for the price of one.
Can I have my wallet back?
All signs point to no.
This may sound a bit insensitive, but how old are you? What's your favorite animal? No, I'm serious. I really want to know your age. I like elephants. Look, I think there's been a misunderstanding. When your profile said you were still in school, I assumed you meant college. That's very lifelike.
Do you have a scar? I have a scar. Do you want to see it?
No, that's all right.
I got a paintball. Do you see it?
Honestly, how old are you?
This many. Will you be my girlfriend?
Your girlfriend?
Because Katie Johnson always screams boring when she's school. And Courtney Taylor smells like horses.
You've got a lot of girlfriends.
Yeah.
Will you be my girlfriend? Sure, but only if you pay for dinner.
Okay.
You sort of have the wrong idea. On multiple levels.
These prices are outrageous!
Look, I'm not interested in male companionship or pirate companionship.
Companionship? Your skull be whole! No more. What I be searching for is a sturdy crew of buccaneers to join me quest for the hidden treasure of Crossbones Cove!
I gotta go. My, ship is double parked.
Sure, I hate when that happens.
Oh, deja vu all over again.
You can say that again.
Deja vu all... Never mind.
Right. So, you're dating again?
You can say that. You too?
Mm-hmm.
So how's it going?
Oh, great. Really fantastic.
Me too. I'm having a great time.
All right. No, it's awful.
Yeah, okay, fine. Same.
So, I was wondering, I was thinking, I know it's probably not the best idea to get back together just because the dating pool sucks.
Yeah.
Though it feels less like a dating pool, more like a kiddie pool. You know how kiddie pools are mostly.
No, I get this.
All right. So, I think it's unhealthy.
Unhealthy to restart a relationship out of desperation. I agree.
Good.
So, this is what I was thinking. We were boyfriend and girlfriend before we were ever friends. So, what if we start at scratch, just as friends, and just take it a day at a time?
Day at a time, I like it.
All right.
Let's give it a shot.
So, you want ice cream?
Believe it or not, I do like ice cream.
I thought you might.
Please don't tell me you're psychic now.
Just one stipulation before we give this whole friends a shot.
Yeah?
We set fire to your Captain McCauley costume.
Deal.
I heard that, and I cursed your very soul! Ahoy there. Be there a chance that ye be a sea roving buccaneer, because I be in dire need of a first mate.
Check, please. Sure.
Nice to meet you.
Same here.
I like your shirt.
Thanks.
This guy Frank I knew in college had the same one.
Frank's a copycat.
So, what's your favorite hobby?
Well, my new guilty pleasure is karaoke.
I love karaoke. I used to go with this driver who sang Don't Stop Believin' literally every time. Actually, coincidence, it's the same guy with the shirt.
Frank?
Frank!
Frank's got great taste in shirts and dumb hobbies. So, how long have you lived in town?
About a year. I moved to be closer to my best friends. Tracy from high school, Denise from preschool, Frank, Janine, Claire, Frank, Allison.
What about Frank?
Oh, right, Frank. Frank is one of my closest friends.
Not my favorite.
You know how it's impossible for guys and girls to be just friends? Frank and I are one exception.
That's great.
I mean, we did date once, a long time ago, but just for a few weeks. Or it might have been a couple of months. 8 years. It's bad for us to talk about next. Frank taught me that.
Smart idea.
Thank you so much for listening to me.
Hold on a second. Did you say thank you?
No, I said thank you. Anyways, what were we talking about a second ago? I'm drawing Frank.
Okay. You definitely said Frank at that time.
What? I did not! This is freaking ridiculous!
May I take your order?
Oh, yes, I would love to order.
Seriously? We broke up years ago. Quit stalking me.
Who was that guy?
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Likewise.
All right. I have to ask about Frank back. Is it true what Cheryl told me that you're fluent in a bunch of different languages?
Yeah.
That's so cool.
Thanks.
Seriously, like, everybody I know just knows English and maybe like 8 words in Spanish or French.
Really?
Seriously. Including me. Like, if I went to Mexico right now, I'd probably only be able to find a bathroom and maybe a library.
I'm sure you know more than you think. I get rusty all the time.
So how many do you know?
I'm not sure. I was kind of a while back.
Are you serious? I'm genuinely impressed. Wait, so would it be weird to ask you to speak in some different languages?
I'd rather not.
Oh, come on, please.
I don't want to look like I'm showing off.
No, just a few.
Alright, I'll give you a sample. Let's see, if I wanted to say, it's a pleasure to meet you in Latin, I would say, a possibilum incarbe diem et summa cum laude.
Really? That sounds familiar.
It's a fairly common expression. I've studied in classics in college for 3 years.
Well, you definitely would look to know better than me. What else?
Well, there's a ton. For instance, if I wanted to tell you, you look beautiful in the color green, I would say, mille grazie di nero e di caprio calzone.
Did you just say DiCaprio?
Yeah, it's color, cute.
Oh.
Then in German, if I wanted to say, excuse me, waiter, my soup is cold, I would say, auf Wiedersehen, breakfast, dinner, pussy. In French, hold on a second, would be loosely translated as, de nuit, de l'ouest, à la baguette.
Wait.
In Hebrew, that's drader, drader, drader.
Okay, stop. This is insulting. I mean, if you were joking, that would be one thing, but it honestly seems like you're trying to convince me that you know all these different languages. Do you know a single foreign language, or just a terrible liar?
Taco.
Hi, my fellow American. It is an honor and a privilege to spend this moment with the magnificent citizens of our country.
Yeah, likewise. So, I'm going to take a guess and say that you're into politics.
Now is the time to abandon partisan politics. We must bridge the divide, reach across the aisle, and at long last dispense with the same old Washington games. Politics? Not if I have anything to say about it.
So politics.
My record on that issue has been clearly stated.
Okay, so where are you from?
I was born in a small Missouri town called Soot. It's a humble town full of hard-working families, rolling prairies, and goats. The first thing you learn as a citizen of Soot is the difference between a good oat and a bad oat. A good oat feeds families. A good oat can be trusted. A bad oat, well, a bad oat can leave a bitter taste in a young child's mouth. A bad oat cannot be trusted. A bad oat will destroy your home and steal your take-home pay.
Can I start you off with anything?
Sure, I'll have the goat cheese truffle.
And for you?
My esteemed colleague wishes for the goat cheese truffles. I, on the other hand, wish to improve our schools, reduce deficit spending, and keep the government out of big, out the pocket of big business.
Coming right up.
I have traveled across this fine land, and I've shaken the hands of real Americans just like you. Take this 60-year-old mill worker I met in Stone Ridge, Ohio. His name was Gort. Now, Gort may have a ridiculous name, but Gort does not have a ridiculous heart. Gort spoke to me about what we need in this country. That what we need is a leader who leads. Not a leader who doesn't lead. That would be a waste of the first four letters of leader. Or the young woman I met in Great Bend, Kansas. Her name was Lynn, and she was a zookeeper. She may have shoveled crap for a living, but she was not full of leaves. A date which will live in infamy.
That was offensive. Listen, I don't mind politics. In fact, I'm glad you're so dedicated to improving the country. I'd just rather not talk about it right now. Can you please change the subject?
It is time for a change.
No, a new conversation.
Time for a new beginning.
No.
A new dawn.
I'm Ruth Hayes, and I approve this message.
You know, I just realized something that I feel you should know. I'm not registered to vote.
You got freaking kidding me!
Holly! Hi!
I lost 100 pounds.
Oh, wow.
You won't believe me.
No, I believe you.
Believe this! Guess who's wearing those pants?
You?
Me. I used to wear those pants. Some people survive something like that. Others wear the Atkins. Me, I used to wear three words. Determination, hard work, onions.
Onions.
I serve every day with an onion smoothie. Then for lunch, I would do a running lunch. Boiled chicken, pile of onions and flavor to slabs of onions. And then for dinner?
Let me guess, an onion.
An onion!
Does it ever get boring for you?
Well, once a week I splurge for a little time, so a day. But it was all worth it. Because look what 4 years of onions can do. Do you know what most of the weight goes on the grandpa's overweight?
I don't know.
Hips, gut, thighs, wrong. The answer is skull. Now it's 300 pounds, 112 live right here.
I didn't know that was possible.
Are you kidding me?
No.
Are you kidding me?
No.
I should also mention that the rest of the weight went to my waist!
Do you carry those pants around with you everywhere?
What, these pants? No, not really. Seldom, infrequently, occasionally, sometimes.
Always?
Yeah, all the time.
Don't get me wrong, I'm really impressed with what you've
accomplished. I know, I bet.
But I'd really rather you not take out your oversized pants again.
Oh, okay. That's right.
It's just not really dinner appropriate.
No, you're right. It's not. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
But check out these bad boys!
Everybody clap your hands!
Can you break to the top? Let you never get stop.
Oh my gosh, my hand is here. I gotta leave. Thank you for your treat.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Why are they leaving again?
Because they're idiots.
I went to college at Ohio State.
Ohio State, yes. Go on.
I was an English major, but I minored in astronomy.
Astronomy, yes. All of this is obvious. Any details?
I don't understand. How is this obvious?
Have you ever been on a date before? Fine. Well, let me show you. Ask me questions about your life.
Where am I from?
Baltimore.
What are my parents' names?
Steve and Joanne.
What was my MCAT score?
You didn't take the MCAT. But you got 27 on the ACT.
On the SAT. That's amazing.
Child's play. Your family's dog's name is Dexter. He was killed by 2001 Toyota Camry when you were 10. You got straight A's all throughout middle school, except when you failed your class with suspect volleyball. You got second place in your ninth grade spelling bee, the smuggler, and a monitor. You have a phobia of nurses and coming peacocks. And you love black licorice, but hate swizzlers. And your blood type? That's AB positive. We didn't know that until I told you, because you've never given blood. Ask me something.
I don't know whether to be impressed or creeped out, but I think I'm just creeped out.
All this information is publicly available. Have you ever heard of the internet? I bet you don't need to for email.
Actually, yeah.
Seriously? What are you? Traffic 2021?
You found all of that about me online?
Of course. Why else do you think they invented Google, Facebook, Tumblr, eHarmony, Match.com, LinkedIn, Snapchat, TikTok, and Ticketmaster?
Ticketmaster?
You bought two tickets to the Kenny Chesney concert in the summer of 2019.
Okay, so tell me about you.
Seriously? Who doesn't research your date in advance? Do your homework. Here, I'll do it. Do you know what you can do with it?
In a world where anything can happen, one man goes on a date with a woman.
It's nice to meet you, too.
Once in a lifetime, a moment comes along that changes us forever. She's from the mean streets of South Central.
Actually, South Dakota.
He's a renegade cop.
You're a renegade cop?
Together, they might just make the perfect pair.
Okay, let's...
From Marvel Studios and the producers that brought you Endgame, comes the conversation 45 seconds in the making.
Is there a reason why you're doing that impression of that movie trailer voice?
That voice is mine.
That's you? That's your job?
It is.
Okay, that's pretty cool, but still, it'd be less weird if you just talked in your normal speaking voice.
I've been the official preview voice for so long that I've forgotten how to speak like a normal person. It's made life harder than you think. I find it difficult to show emotion. For example, here's what it sounds like when I see something exciting. I can't believe my team won the Super Bowl. What about that catch in the game-winning drive? What a play. I'm freaking out.
Ooh. It does do something in translation.
Or last week, when my friend's grandmother died. It's hard to sound sincere when I said this. I'm sorry for your loss. Grams was a wonderful woman. My condolences to you and your family.
It must be hard for you.
It's made me clinically depressed.
Well, what if we try to fix your problem?
I'm fairly certain it can't be fixed.
We could try. Here, give me an example act from one of your movie trailers.
In a world where parakeets rule, one man.
Okay, there. Try to say in a world again.
In a world.
Right, but this time, say like I do. In a world.
In a world.
Better try again.
In a world.
Maybe try saying inside the planet.
In a world.
Oh, forget it. I can't stand you're gonna talk like that for the rest of the day.
Before you go, can you do me one favor?
What?
Can you give me a ride home?
You have a car?
I can't afford a car.
Hollywood celebrity, shouldn't you have a lot of money?
In a world of plastic surgery and million-dollar makeovers, one man risked it all. And now he's broke and lives with his mom.
Hi, broke, right?
Yes.
So, this place looks pretty cool.
Yes.
You've been here before?
Yes.
Is it good?
Yes.
Well, that's good to hear.
Yes.
So, you live downtown, right?
Yes.
You don't like it?
Yes.
Say anything other than yes?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
Are you going to tell me?
No.
You speak English, right?
Yes.
Ah, great. Food?
Yes.
Wait, you said more than yes, right?
Do I say more than yes?
Okay, good, then. I'll have the chicken salad on the tray with the gazpacho to start.
Ma'am? Yes. Can I get you something? Yes.
Here, allow me. Do you want an appetizer?
Yes.
Soup?
No.
Salad?
Yes.
Caesar salad?
No.
Garden salad?
Yes.
Dressing?
Yes.
Can you help me out here?
Yes. Blue cheese, no French, no French, no beef fabric, no French, no balsamic vinaigrette. Yes. Next in? No. On the side? Yes. We have 34 entrees for chicken. Would you like the ground salmon? No. Roast chicken? No. Spare ribs? No. Duck a la ranch?
You know what? Why don't we just start with the salad right now?
Very good, sir.
No. Oh, is that why you're only answering with yes or no?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yes. Yes.
So, your answers haven't really corresponded to any of my questions at all, have I?
Yes.
What's 2 plus 2?
Yes.
What's the capital of Oregon?
No.
Do you kick puppies for a living?
Yes.
What's your opinion on random words like triceratops, dodgeball, and Miley Cyrus?
No, yes, yes.
So, I guess the real question is, Italiano, Francais, Espanol.
Espanol, gracias a Dios.
Outside of the box, win-win situations, giving 110%,
maximizing leverage, pushing the envelope, squaring the circle, and finally, making sure to call ahead if one of us is going to be late for a movie or something. I think you'll agree that as a disruptive innovation, this is a value-added proposition. Now, I believe if we run up the flagpole to see who swims, if we skate to where the puck is going, if we stick a fork in it to see if it's done, if we tickle the artichoke until it seems dancing queen, then I guarantee that this merger will bear fruit. And by fruit, I am, of course, in no way referring to babies. Unless you wouldn't want to talk about it. But if not, that's also cool. I want four. Any questions?
I do have one question.
Excuse me, who said that? You?
Could you tell me how it's possible that I've actually had worse dates than this one?
They need these pie charts, huh?
I need to go powder my nose. Oh, hey, what are you doing here? I was just texting you. Save me.
Save me too. So, I thought for a long time about what you said at the wedding, or what you screamed at the wedding. I realized that for 2 years, I've been texting you escape plans from the bathroom, but never went up with you.
Same here, like, all I can think about now is us doing laundry together instead of listening to whatever garbage this guy was talking about.
How's it going?
So, I think we should stop living on the whole thing. We should just do the whole thing, which sucks, because I'm allergic to pepper. What I'm saying is, will you come to dinner with me?
Yes.
But not just one dinner. All the dinners.
Check, please.
Thank you. this, and I love this. This was my favorite place that I've done in the past 4 years that I've been in drama club. And I would also just like to acknowledge everybody that helped us, obviously. So we have flowers for Miss D and Miss O. Here you go.
Performance, I end up having to fill in again, and there's two roles under my belt. So this year I'm like, you know, I'll join from the beginning, so then I don't have to learn my role in 2 years. And that's what I did, and so I thank you so much for giving me the chance to be Guy, being on the stage has been such a blessing this year, and I see as I cannot thank you enough. And I see the language out there in the crowd, I'm in this because of you. So thank you.
I'm gonna miss you so much, but I will come back. You will see me.